In the previous tutorial, we have learned how to create these drawings. Now, in this tutorial, we will learn how to give dimensions to these drawings. If you want to learn how to create these drawings, then link to those tutorials is given in the description. And if you want to learn complete AutoCAD from basic level, then link to complete playlist is given in the description. At first, we will open the drawings which we have created in the previous tutorials. Click on Open Files, then scroll it down, then select files you want to open. If you want to select multiple files, then you can press Ctrl and select as many files as you want and click on Open. All those files will get opened. Then from here you can switch to other drawings. So all the three drawings has been opened. We will start dimensioning this drawing. At first we will give these dimensions. Click on dimension. Then take your cursor over the line and click. And take your cursor below and click. Then to give continue dimension, click on continue. Then specify first extension line origin. Click on this side. Then specify second extension line origin. Click on these points, this point and this point. Then press escape. Press escape to cancel the dimension command. Now these dimensions are not properly visible. To increase the size, click on annotation, click on dimension style, click on modify, click on fit, and from here you can increase the scale. Suppose I will make it 4. OK, close. Now these dimensions are properly visible. Then next we will give these vertical dimensions. Click on dimension, click on this line. Take your cursor outside and click. Then click on this line, click. Click on this line, click. Then click on this line and click. Then next is to give this circle dimensions. We will have to give location dimensions, then radius and diameter. Take your cursor on this endpoint, click there. Then take your cursor on this center point, click. Then take your cursor above on the left side, then it will convert it into horizontal dimension. And if you want to force it to be horizontal, then for that make ortho on. Then dimension will come horizontal automatically. Click. Then click on this node. Click on this midpoint. Take your cursor on the right side and click. Then click on this circle. Now here, this is radius. To convert this diameter into radius, click on radius and click. Then click on this center point. Click on this midpoint. Take your cursor on this side and click. Then again, take your cursor on this node. Then click on this midpoint. Take your cursor below and click. Then take your cursor on this circle and click. Now we want to give diameter dimension here. For that, click on diameter and click and press escape. So all the dimensions has been given. Then next is this drawing. This one. At first we will give these dimensions. Now in this drawing we have already created some layers. We will create one more layer for dimension. Click on layer properties. Click on new layer. Then name it as dim. Then click here and change the color. Okay. Then line width. I will make it 0.20. Okay. Then close this dialog box. Then click on dimension. Then click on this endpoint, click on this endpoint. Then take your cursor above and click. Then click on this endpoint. Again on this endpoint, take your cursor on this side. To force it to be vertical, make ortho on. Then it will come vertical automatically. Click. Then click on this endpoint. Click on this endpoint. Take your cursor outside. Then take your cursor to this endpoint. Take your cursor below. It will track that point and click. Then click on this endpoint. Click on this endpoint. Take it outside and click. And escape. Now these dimensions are very small. To increase the size, you will have to give dimension style. Keyboard shortcut for dimension style is D and enter. Then modify. Then we will increase the scale to 2. Okay, close. Now these dimensions are properly visible. Then next is this 20, 30 and 30. Click on dimension. Click on this endpoint. Then now here it is not showing center point of circle. To show the center point of circle, take your cursor on circle, then it will show the center point. Click there, take your cursor above and click. Then click on this endpoint, take your cursor below and click. Then to give the angle, click on this line, click on this line. Then take your cursor inside and click. Then next is these dimensions. Click on this line, take your cursor below and click. Then click on this arc. Don't take your cursor on any object snap, otherwise it will not select that object. Zoom there. Then take your cursor in this portion. Take your cursor below and click. Then radius on this side. Click on this. Take your cursor above and click. Then angle between these two lines. Click on this line. Click on this line. Take your cursor inside and click. Then click on this inclined line. Now it is not showing align dimension. To show the align dimension, you will have to make ortho off. Then give the position. So all these dimensions has been given. Then next is this one, tools dia 20. Click on this circle, take your cursor outside and click. Then press escape. Then double click on this dia 20. Then type two holes. Then dia 20 is already there, click outside. Then press escape. Then to make it horizontal, you will have to update settings in dimension style. Type D, enter for dimension style. Click on modify, click on text, and click on this ISO standard so that these outside dimensions will become horizontal. Click on OK, click on close. Then to shift it above, click on this dimension. Then click on this blue grip, then give the desired location, click, escape. Then next is this dimension using leader. Click on leader. Then to catch this point, press shift and right click and click on nearest. Then click. Take your cursor above and click and type R120 and for multiplication sign type X R25. Click outside. Then same way on this ellipse, and it is ellipse R130 R20. What we can do, we can copy this leader here. Click on copy. Select this leader, enter, then base point will be this end point. Then again press shift and right click and select nearest and click on this ellipse and escape. Then dimension for this ellipse is 130 and 20. Double click, make here 130 and here 20. Click outside. Now the size of dimension text for leader is smaller than our dimension style. So for that, click on annotation, click on multi-leader style, click on modify. Then here, make this text height to be 2.5, and in leader format, make this arrow size to be 2.5, and in leader structure, specify the scale of 2. Okay, close. Now these dimensions are matching. Then to change the layers of all the dimensions, select all the dimensions. Then click here and click on dim. Press escape. Then next is this one. At first we will import the dimension layer from 5.2. For that type DC, enter, then click on this plus before the 5.2, click on layers, and here is the dim layer. Click it, then press and hold first mouse button, drag it and release it in this current drawing. Then close this dialog box. Now here is the dim layer. Then by clicking on this box, you can change the color. Suppose I want this one. Okay. Then make dim layer current. Then at first we will give these three dimensions. Click on dimension. Click on this endpoint. Zoom there. Click on this endpoint. Take your cursor below and click. Then click on this endpoint. And click on this endpoint. Then take your cursor below and click. Then click on this arc and click. Then next is this length. Click on this line, take your cursor above and click. Then click on this line, click on this endpoint. Then this 2x2 chamfer. For that we will have to use leader, press escape. Click on leader, click on this midpoint, take your cursor above. To make this line inclined, make this ortho off. Then click, zoom minus, click, and type there 2x2, enter, then bracket, typical, closing bracket, click outside. Now the size of this leader is larger. To reduce the size, click on annotation, click on multi-leader style, click on modify, then click on leader format, then change the size of this arrowhead to 2.5. We are giving here 2.5 because in ISO the size of arrowhead is 2.5 and size of text is also 2.5. That means we are matching these values with the values given in dimension style. Okay, close. Now the size is matching. Then next is this vertical dimensions. For that, click on dimension. Then click on this endpoint. Click on this endpoint. Take your cursor outside and click. Again, click on this endpoint. Click on this endpoint. And click. Then these dimensions, click on this endpoint, click on this endpoint, take your cursor outside and click. And click on this endpoint, click on this endpoint, take your cursor outside and click. Then on this endpoint and this endpoint, take it outside and click and escape. Now for this vertical dimensions, diameter symbol is given. To add this diameter symbol, type D for dimension style, enter, then we will have to create one copy of this ISO 25 dimension style. For that, click on new, then remove this, then name it as dia and continue. Then click on primary units, and in this prefix type %C, then OK, then close. Then select these dimensions, then click here on annotation, click here and select this dimension style ISO 25 dia and escape. In this way you can add diameter symbol. So this drawing is also ready. So dimensions has been given to all the drawings. In the next tutorial we will learn next set of commands, and we will solve some exercises based on those commands, and we will also continue our tutorials for civil, interior, mechanical, electrical, electronics and chemical engineering. So thanks for watching. We will stop here.